In the previous video, hybrid electric vehicles were discussed in details. In this video, the types of hybrid electric vehicles will be discussed. As we know that a hybrid car uses more than one means of energy, combining a petrol or diesel engine with an electric motor, and the two systems work with each other to move the vehicle. This allows the car to burn less gasoline, achieving better fuel efficiency than a traditional engine that solely uses fuel does. The system recollects energy via regenerative braking and by the internal combustion engine. The operating mode can be changed and shifted while driving, which means that the car can alter between a gas engine and an electric motor. Sometimes, it can use both to enhance the car's performance. Now that you know what hybrid car means, it is time to understand what's a hybrid car types available in the market. There are three main types of hybrid cars, each with advantages and disadvantages. Mild hybrid vehicles, also called micro hybrids, full hybrid vehicles, or self-charging hybrid. Full hybrid have a types, series mode, parallel mode, or power split hybrids. Plug-in hybrid electric vehicles. And the fourth one may be considered as a fuel cell electric vehicle. Mild hybrid vehicles. It is the newest innovation in hybrid technology. In this type of hybrid, an electric motor is unable to propel the vehicle on its own. The majority of the work done by conventional gasoline or diesel engine, while an electric motor assists the conventional engine by either increasing performance, decreasing fuel consumption, or both. This small electric assistance helps support the petrol or diesel engine and helps reduce the amount of fuel it burns, making it more efficient. This leads to better fuel economy, meaning that your fuel bills are a little lower than they would otherwise be and you get lower CO2 emissions from the exhaust. Some systems also allow the engine to be switched off for short periods while the car is traveling at a steady speed, further improving efficiency. The advantages are lower emissions, reduced running costs, smoother ride, lower purchase cost, while the disadvantages are more mechanical pieces, limited improvement in efficiency, more expensive than non-hybrid cars, and small number of models so far. Full hybrid vehicles. This type of hybrid supports both electrical components and a conventional engine. In full hybrid cars, the electric component can handle more workload than in a mild hybrid car. Full hybrids use both a combustion engine and an electric motor to drive, either at the same time or independently. They have an electric system that drives the powertrain. The electric motor usually handles city driving, and the IC engine takes over for highway driving. Full hybrid cars are capable of traveling really short distances on electric power only. Full hybrid vehicles have complete access to all features offered by hybrid technology. These vehicles have a large battery pack located in the boot that powers the electric motors. At a certain speed, these vehicles can be powered by batteries only, enabling them to independently operate without any input from the engine. In case the battery gets depleted, the generator pulls power from the engine and charges the batteries. They are also able to operate in series mode, parallel mode, or power split hybrids. Parallel hybrids. This is the most common sort of full hybrid, which combine the power of an electric motor and a gasoline engine through a single transmission. The cars are either directly powered by a gas engine, by an electric motor, or by a combination of both. Series hybrids. In this hybrid mode, the gasoline engine is not connected to the wheels and is only used to produce electricity for a generator that serves energy to recharge the battery. There is never physical mechanical contact between the engine and the wheels, and the electric motor serves to provide all the propulsion. Series parallel hybrids, or power split hybrids. Series and parallel hybrid drives can also be combined in one vehicle with power split or series parallel hybrids, as they are also known. The driver chooses one of the two drives. Advantages of full hybrid vehicles: retain a higher value throughout their lifespan than a mild hybrids. They also have greater fuel savings and a reduced environmental impact. Disadvantages: however, full hybrids may be more expensive to maintain because of the added engine complexity. Plug-in hybrid electric vehicles. As the name plug-in hybrid suggests, this type of hybrid can be plugged into an external electrical socket as well as charged while on the road. It is actually in between traditional hybrids and fully electric vehicles, which means that it has a conventional engine but larger batteries than typical hybrids, which allows you to drive on only electric power for up to 30 to 55 miles before switching to a petrol engine. Moreover, after all the electric power used up, the car reverts to a conventional parallel hybrid. You don't need to worry about topping the batteries up if you need to go further, because the conventional engine automatically kicks in and takes over when the batteries are depleted. Advantages of plug-in hybrid cars are: electric power for more than 20 miles, cheap to run using up to 30% less fuel per mile than regular fuel cars, environmentally efficient, reliable. Plug-in hybrids can be more reliable than petrol or diesel cars. The engine doesn't keep running when you're driving slowly or in urban settings, which results in a lot less wear and tear. Disadvantages of plug-in hybrid cars: higher price out of the showroom. Plug-in hybrid vehicle include its heavy battery, which can cause it to get worse mileage compared to a non-hybrid vehicle when running exclusively on the combustion engine. The battery packs are expensive, too, and have costly maintenance. Note that a fuel cell electric vehicle might be considered a fourth type of hybrid car, but it's not widely available right now. Instead of using gasoline, these PHEVs hybrids use a hydrogen fuel cell that has zero emissions. Only water vapor and hot air come out of the tailpipe. If the pros and cons of hybrid cars on the environment are a major factor for you, and hydrogen fuel cell vehicles may be an attractive option once refueling stations become more common. Fuel cell cars are powered by compressed hydrogen gas that feeds into an onboard fuel cell stack that doesn't burn the gas, but instead transforms the fuel's chemical energy into electrical energy. This electricity then powers the car's electric motors. Tailpipe emissions are zero, and the only waste produced is pure water. The construction of the fuel cell is similar to a battery. Hydrogen enters the anode, where it comes in contact with a catalyst that promotes the separation of hydrogen atoms into an electron and proton. The electrons are gathered by the conductive current collector, which is connected to the car's high-voltage circuitry, feeding the onboard battery and/or the motors that turn the wheels. Thanks for watching the video. For more videos, subscribe to my channel.